Day 18. Are you with me? Then I said to them, You see the trouble we are in. Jerusalem lies in ruins, and its gates have been burned with fire. Come, let us rebuild the wall of Jerusalem, and we will no longer be in disgrace. I also told them about the gracious hand of my God upon me, and what the king had said to me. They replied, Let us start rebuilding. Nehemiah 2:17-18. While money can't buy happiness, it certainly lets you choose your own form of misery. Groucho Marx. Oh, that the pleasure-seeking men and women of the world would only taste and feel the real joy of those who know and love the true God, a heritage which the world cannot give to them, but which the poorest and humblest of followers of Jesus know. John Patton, missionary. I am reminded of a classic line from C.S. Lewis's The Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. Just before the great battle between good and evil, the boy king, Peter, says to the half-horse, half-man creature who pledged to fight alongside the sons of Adam, Are you with me? A simple yes, sir, or I think, or why not, would have sufficed, but this involved life and death. He turned to Peter and said, Until the death. That is devotion. Someone who says, I believe in you, I am with you, and I will fight for you until the finish line or till death, whichever comes first, is devoted to you. Nehemiah went back to his people and said two things. Strategically, the first was glaringly obvious. We are in desperate trouble. This place is a mess and has literally been burnt down. Let's rebuild it to get out of this awful disgrace. Second, Nehemiah said, God had been very good to him and opened up many doors that could not have been opened by human hands. Even the king himself had written letters to help. God had done some incredible miracles and even used a man who had no incentive to come to their aid. Now write down 10 essential financial miracles that you need and make a promise to God that you will not presume upon him or rescue him. If he forgets his checkbook, you do not have to swipe your credit card. He owns the cattle on 1,000 hills. He also owns the silver and gold. So if your God forgets his checkbook, you better upgrade to a bigger God today. Next time you are at that familiar crossroad, the one where you have the choice to charge something you need, your mind says, I have a brain and a credit card, so I'll swipe it. God has not designed us for this type of spiritual conflict. Trusting God does not mean going without our needs. God has promised to take care of our needs and give us joy, peace, and hope through all of the hills and valleys we traverse. Our minds say, this can't be true. Our hearts have always said, I wish it were true. It is true. Trust him this time.